Born in 1825 in the old Cape Colony, your family trekked away, searching to be free. You were born and brought up on a wild frontier, became a soldier and a president, but you were a pioneer. They say you knew the Bible off by heart. I'm sure you often pondered a while upon the part in Genesis chapter 1, in the 28th verse, where the good Lord commanded us all to conserve. Uncle Paul, you started it all long ago in the days of the old Transvaal. It was back in 1898. You stopped the overkill to save wild animals from their fate. Though you were a ruthless hunter yourself, you realized the biggest prize was Mother Nature's wealth. Between the Crocodile River and the wild sardine, you gave God's creation a special sanctuary. For reasons absurd came the tragedy of war. It was guns that were heard, not the lion's roar. And the quest to feed the soldiers, overkill began again. Paradise became a battlefield, your dream seemed all in vain. Uncle Paul, you started it all long ago in the days of the old Transvaal. It was back in 1898. You stopped the overkill to save wild animals from their fate. Uncle Paul was a defeated, heartbroken president. Away to Europe, in exile he was sent. Other wars ended and other wars began, and the miners and the farmers came looking for land. But his legacy stood firm and a park was proclaimed from the Limpopo in the north, bearing his name, to the Crocodile River in the south in 1926. Minister Pete Krobler got the borders fixed. Uncle Paul, you started it all long ago in the days of the old Transvaal. It was back in 1898. You stopped the overkill to save wild animals from their fate. Now Noah saved the animals in his ark. Uncle Paul did much the same with Kruger Park. And the story of the Kruger Millions never dies. They're in the form of animals right before your eyes. Uncle Paul, you started it all long ago in the days of the old Transvaal. It was back in 1898. You stopped the overkill to save wild animals from